plants actually need three most important nutrients. The three important minerals are nitrogen, represented chemically as N, phosphorus, represented chemically as P, potassium, represented chemically as K. This is why the important fertilizer that is sold in the market is known as NPK fertilizer. Plants must have these nutrients in order to grow healthy and strong. I will make individual videos on each of these major nutrients required by plants. In these videos, I will also share the various organic sources of these nutrients that can be used for your plants, instead of the inorganic chemical fertilizers. In this video I have explained in brief about the usage of nitrogen to plants and organic sources of nitrogen. Also, see the video till the end to know the most richest sources of organic nitrogen for your plants. Most importantly, the video also contains ways by which you can find out if your garden soil has more nitrogen or less nitrogen, based on the plant's growth. I have divided this video into three parts for easy understanding. Part 1. Why plants like nitrogen. Part 2. How to find out if your garden soil has less nitrogen or more nitrogen. Part 3. The organic sources of nitrogen. Okay, now moving on to the first part of the video. Why plants like nitrogen? Nitrogen helps plants use carbohydrates to gain energy, just like certain foods we eat help us to gain energy. Nitrogen controls how plants take their form and how they function inside. And nitrogen helps plants make protein that help them grow strong and healthy. It is the most imperative element for proper growth and development of plants, which significantly increases and enhances the yield, and also increases the food quality. Without nitrogen, a plant cannot make the proteins, amino acids, and even its very DNA. This is why when there is a nitrogen deficiency in the soil, plants are stunted. They simply cannot make their own cells. We will now see the second part of the video, to know what happens when plants don't get enough nitrogen. Plants deficient in nitrogen have thin, spindly stems and the growth is stunted. Their older leaves turn yellowish-green from nitrogen starvation, chlorosis, while newer leaves are supplied with the available but limited nitrogen. What happens when plants get too much nitrogen? Plants that get too much nitrogen have a lot of foliage, leaf growth, but are not strong. Plants that are not strong can get diseases more easily, can be bothered more by bugs, and can eventually fall over and die. An excess amount of nitrogen in plants can affect the amount of sugar and vitamins in fruits and vegetables, making them taste different. More importantly, excess nitrogen can build up in plant tissues, causing toxicity, poisoning, in livestock and in small children who eat nitrogen-rich leafy vegetables. Now we will move on to the third part of the video, to know how to correct nitrogen deficiency in your garden soil using organic methods. To correct a nitrogen deficiency using organic methods requires time, but will result in a more even distribution of the added nitrogen over time. Some organic methods of adding nitrogen to the soil include 1. Adding composted manure to the soil. Using manure compost in the garden has numerous benefits. Manure is packed with nutrients that plants need, like nitrogen. Using manure as fertilizer keeps plants healthy and green. 2. Planting a green manure crop, such as borage. 3. Planting nitrogen-fixing plants like peas or beans. Most plants must rely on the addition of nitrogen to the soil in order to be able to use it. There are a few plants that love nitrogen gas, though they are able to draw the nitrogen gas from the air and store it in their roots. These are called nitrogen-fixing plants. 4. Adding coffee grounds to the soil. Composting coffee grounds helps to add nitrogen to your compost pile. I have also made a video on the various benefits of adding coffee grounds to your garden soil. The link to the video is also given in the description box, or it is given here on top in the card. You can see that video after watching this one. Now, let's move on to the most important part of the video. The richest organic sources of nitrogen. We have come to the last part of the video, but the most important part. The richest organic sources of nitrogen are 1. Manures. 2. Ground up animal parts such as blood meal, feather dust, leather dust, and 3. Seed meals such as soybean meal, cottonseed meal.